I love high-end makeup, but I love it even more whenever I can buy it on sale, so that's usually how I afford and purchase my high-end makeup. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Hannah. Surprisingly, we are already at the end of another month, which is very surprising to me. We're halfway through 2019, which is crazy. That also means that it's time for my monthly beauty favorites again. So if you're excited to see what beauty products I have to recommend to you guys, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Also, I think I said my name is Hannah. If not, hi, my name is Hannah. I upload beauty videos every Monday and Friday, so feel free to stick around and subscribe. And if you want to see the beauty products that I recommend and that I've been loving in the month of June, make sure you keep on watching. Once again, I don't have a lot to recommend, but to me, that's almost a little bit better because, you know, rather than recommending like 10 to 15 of the same ones, which, I mean, that's fine if, you know, there's people that do that. But regardless, these are beauty products that I don't think I've spoken about them, or at least not that much on my channel, so that's kind of exciting. We have some new favorites to recommend to you guys. The first thing that I want to mention is this Bright Citrus Serum. I mentioned I actually in a haul that I will link for you guys. I got this in my Spring Editors sale from FabFitFun. This is from the brand, I believe it's pronounced Rosen. But this is just a Bright Citrus Serum. If I can find this and link it for you guys, I will. It's pretty affordable from what I recommend, from what I remember rather. But I really like this because I have acne scarring and discoloration, because I still get acne every now and then, but I had it really bad on my cheek area there for a little while. So I kind of have acne scarring from that, and I think that this has really helped. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I've not used it the past couple nights, but other than that, I have been pretty good with using this almost every single night, and I just apply a couple drops. I mostly just concentrated on this area because that's where I've noticed the discoloration, but you can apply it all over your face, obviously avoiding the eye area. But after I cleanse my face and apply, I also use micellar water to just kind of make sure that I remove all of my makeup. I go ahead and put a couple drops on each of my cheeks, and then I go in with moisturizer, and I just think that that's really helped. So that's kind of one thing that I wanted to recommend to you guys. Eventually, I feel like I will do an updated skincare system, but I did want at least to mention that if you were interested in trying out vitamin C serums, I can't say, you know, like, yes, every single one will work out, but there are a lot of brands who have a vitamin C serum. I feel like it's a really popular item that I've noticed lately, and I really like it, so that's just kind of my thoughts on that. The next product that I have to mention is a very like high-end product, but I actually got this on sale. This is the Natasha Denona Mini Lila Palette. I'm not sure if you can see how dirty this is, but I mean, it just kind of shows how well loved it has been, because this is a recent purchase. I actually got it on sale for $12.50. Normally it's $25, which is crazy for this small of a palette. You only get 5 eyeshadows, but if you're not familiar with Natasha Denona, it's a pretty high-end makeup brand that is sold at Sephora, and I'm sure it's sold on her own website as well. Like, there's larger palettes that are literally over $100, which is crazy to me, but I am really glad that I was able to at least try out a small version of Natasha Denona. It's actually the eyeshadow that I used in this look. I think, yeah, this look is actually going up after my favorites, but after the fact, I will link it for you guys. Cool. If I remember to, this is me reminding myself to do that. But yeah, I just wanted to mention this if you were curious on trying it out, and especially if it's still on sale, I will definitely link it for you guys. I mean, I'll link it for you guys regardless, but hopefully it's still on sale, because to me, $12.50 for 5 really good eyeshadows like that is a really good deal. The next thing that I have to mention is not a beauty, well, it's a beauty product, but it's not makeup. I think I've mentioned this before. Also, I need to clean this, so like just pretend like this is clean. Yeah, sure. This is actually like a hair wrap, or that kind of situation. I got this in my FabFitFun either spring or summer last year, and I used it today. I use it pretty much every time I wash my hair now. I just like putting my hair up in that, and it allows it to dry a little bit. I still do need to, you know, air dry it and then blow dry it afterwards, but it is nice for me to use that immediately after washing my hair, just to kind of get it out of my face, and if I want to go ahead and start applying my makeup and that kind of thing. And I just really, really like it. So I wanted to recommend that. The next thing is actually 2 lip products. It's kind of like a combo. I've been wearing these a lot together, but of course I didn't in this video just because I wanted to go ahead and, you know, start filming another video. But this is the Tarte lip pencil. we'll just call it a lip pencil, maybe a lip crayon. I'm not sure exactly what it's called. But anyway, it's in the shade Latergram. I also got this at Sephora on sale. I think it was about 50% off, but it's just a really pretty nude color. And what I like about this, I love the Urban Decay 24/7 lip pencils, but you do have to sharpen those, which I don't mind too much. I mean, it is a little annoying, but I think that they're great products, so I'm not gonna like let that hinder me from using them or purchasing them. But if you don't like sharpening your lip products, I recommend this one because it is just a twist up like that. So that's kind of nice, and I think that this is a really good nude shade. Also with the Urban Decay 24/7 lip liners, they have a broad range of colors, and from at least from what I saw, I'm not sure if that was just at my specific Sephora, or you know, maybe they have more shades on the Tarte website, but it looked like they were mostly neutral colors, which isn't bad, but sometimes you might want like a bolder color or something like that. So that's why I like the Urban Decay ones. And then the lip crayon that I like going over top of that is another like mauve neutral color, which I love those, that shade range personally, but this is the Trustique lip crayon in the shade Florence Fig, and I've already swatched that for you, and I just think that they go beautifully together, and it is a fairly matte combination whenever you have them together, but it's not like really drying matte, but it does last for a very long time. I love those two separately and together, so just kind of wanted to give another little lip recommendation. I've really been into lip products the more that I've noticed it. I feel like since my lip declutter video, which was a while ago, but I'll still link that for you guys. Since that video, I kind of came to the realization that I really like lip products, not mad about it. So that's just kind of another little recommendation and products that I've been loving in the month of June. The next is this Lancôme mascara. Of course, I used it on my eyes. You know, you guessed it. Let me do a little up close for you guys to see. This is the Lancôme mascara, excuse me, and this, and not shade. Let's try this again. This is the Lancôme mascara, specifically the Hypnose Drama one. Once again, I believe I did get this on sale. I love high-end, if you're not seeing a theme, I love high-end makeup, but I love it even more whenever I can buy it on sale. So that's usually how I afford and purchase my high-end makeup. Actually, I think, well, I did think I had paid full price for this, but we'll get to this guy in a little second, okay. If you're looking for like another mascara recommendation other than the It Cosmetics Superhero Mascara, which y'all should know by now, that is my Holy Grail mascara. This to me is pretty comparable. I think you might be able to get more volume with this, but I mean, I haven't used the It Cosmetics one in a while, so don't quote me on that. I still love that mascara, but this is just the one that I'm currently loving. I think it is great for volume and length, so I just wanted to recommend that to you guys if you were wondering another mascara recommendation. And that brings us to the last product that I kind of teased a little bit ago. This is the Saint Tropez Self Tan Classic. This is specifically the bronzing face lotion. I used it today. If I still do look really pale, just know that in real life I'm like more pale than this. That's just how I am. I like this. I'm pretty sure I paid full price. To me, this does not last as long as the like body self tanner, just like the normal Saint Tropez mousse or lotion. I've used a lot of different ones, but this does not seem to last as long. I don't know if that's just the face products that I'm using. Like, I'm obviously gonna cleanse my face, you know, at night, but I think it does last at least, you know, I'd say probably 2 or 3 days. So not mad about that. I do like this, and I wanted to include it in a favorites because I think it does, you know, look natural, but I might still be on the hunt for one that lasts a little bit longer. If you have any recommendations, let me know in the comments below. Very curious to try that out. But I do like this. It is $30, unfortunately, but if you have a coupon from Ulta or something like that, that would maybe be a good time to buy this. And I just kind of wanted to, you know, throw this out as a little face bronzing recommendation, because at least me personally, like, I feel like my skin is fairly good right now, but I don't want to make it angry and use like a self tanner that's meant for the body on my face. So I'm just going to kind of probably stick with ones that are just for the face. So I just kind of wanted to recommend this to you guys. And those are all my favorites. Once again, they will be linked in the description box. If you found one or more of the products that you're interested in checking out, make sure you check out the description box. If you liked this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. It really helps me out. Also, feel free to stick around and subscribe. I upload beauty videos every Monday and Friday. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you in my next video.